maximum modulation there, nothing. Am I plugged in? Is my thing selected? It's the way these things go.
Fortunately, things were better than I thought. I was simply too tired after all that work to think clearly. But later that evening, there was a very successful ATV net here in San Jose, California at 8:30. So let's have a look at that and see how it went.
Definitely got to go to work on these transmitters. They're just not working right. W2NYC, net control for the Silicon Valley ATV group. Starting the net here. And I'm going to jump off of... Okay. And we'll ask Richard, KJ6RNL, to bring up that V5 plus picture. Let me just switch things here, Richard.
Okay, Ben, I'm transmitting KJ6RNL. Good evening, Ben. Good evening, Nat, everyone out there. I know Jerry's out there. Take it away, Ben.
Yeah, good, good. Leave your picture up. I'm having a hell of a time here. I heard you, Don. I think Don just checked in. Was that you, Don? Okay, you at home? Hey, look at this picture on Richard. Hello, Don. Are you with me? I just said, can you see this gorgeous picture on Richard?
The picture of Potato Head looks better.
He just improved his setup there. He's 100%. All right, we'll exclude you right now because you're not picking it up.
You anyway, like my new head?
Yes, it looks great. Yeah, you can talk while I talk because you're on 2 meters. I'm on UHF. Yeah, it came out really nice. Boy, what a setup you got now. Perfecto, my boy. Beautiful. All right, leave your picture up. Let's see who else we got out there. Hang on. Okay, what about KV6T? Jerry, you with us?
Yeah, I'm here, lurking in the background and admiring Richard's wonderful picture. Gosh, that was worth all the work you did on it, Richard. That's fantastic. I guess I should tell you guys, when you're ready, I'll put my picture up.
Yeah, we're ready. And then after he finishes, Rich, bring yours back up.
Go ahead.
So, I didn't. And, what else? I've been sitting at my computer here for several hours already. I'm getting tired of it. What I'm trying to accomplish in here is, excuse me, guys, I have to answer my phone. I'll send it back to you, Richard, and I'll come back later, okay?
Okay.
There you go. Thank you. What about Don, KAA6TV? You with us?
Oh, you put a picture up?
Yeah, that was my next... Richard's almost taking you out. Did you drop it, Richard?
just now.
Yeah, it's better when it's not transmitting at the same time.
Looking good, Don.
Thank you. By the way, I figured out how to program those Motorola HDs. Unfortunately, they're like 52 channels each, all synthesized, but they're for businessmen.
Okay.
What, you're programming?
I learned how to program them. I can put on any of the business channels, but there's a program on the ham frequency, shortage on that, that does everything else.
Oh, careful, you might be stepping on somebody's license channel.
Oh, I put it on one of those itinerary channels, so one's a license rate.
They're already in there?
They're already pre-programmed.
Nice. Well, you're looking good there. Great picture. Super, super picture. Hang on to your picture. Let me see if Joe, WB6RIY, you with us tonight?
Yep, I'm here, WB6RIY. Good thing you called me. I was ready to fall asleep.
Don't drop it, Don. Let him put his picture up first. Go ahead, Joe. Well, you have to tell us you're up.
Up?
Hey, drop it. He's up. You have to let us know that you are transmitting. Sometimes you can't override Don. That's pretty tough.
He's the king of the frequency here.
Good conditions.
Everybody's got a good picture except Ben.
See what yours looks like, Ben.
No, you're not going to see it. We'll let Richard come back up after you drop it, but you let him know when you're going to drop it, so he brings it back up before you drop it.
Okay, I'm going to drop it on three. One, two, three.
Attaboy, Richard. You got his number. How about W6ATV? Chris, are you with us tonight? Well, that's too bad because I have an announcement here. And I will make that announcement when I see who else is in here. Who else do we have in here on audio or video? Standing by. Okay. Chris is something else. He got everything done on our electrical up at the site. He rewired the box. We have all the outlets in. Everything's done according to code. It's absolutely beautiful. So now we have a new AC system up there. It's all nice. Thought I'd let everybody know. He spent the whole day there with me. Not today. Day before yesterday. And everything turned out absolutely fabulous. That's just the ID. So we're real proud of Chris. He's really been helpful to us. And him and I went out and had a nice dinner after that. So that's where it stands. Okay, Jerry, you ready to come back up?
Yeah, here I am already keying up, but I cannot even make a dent into Richard's picture.
Nobody can. Oh, look at that picture. That's great.
Yeah, nobody can step on Richard now. Fantastic. Yeah. What I was saying before my phone rang is I was trying to design a picture for my ATV ID, like a test picture with my call sign, and so I found a website that had a bunch of test pictures from like mostly commercial TV stations and stuff, and so I picked one I like, and now I am into editing that picture. So I was looking through a bunch of picture editing software that would allow me to put my call sign into it, into a certain space in that test picture. And that was quite a chore for me to pick a, I was looking for a free picture editing software, as being cheap as I am, so I didn't want to buy something for one use. So, but I did find a bunch of, there are several free softwares. So I downloaded one and I'm learning how to use it I'm almost there. I'm just practicing on some pictures, and once I get it done, I think I will download that test picture on to an SD card, and I will have an SD card reader to generate the video, composite video, so I can feed it into the transmitter, so I will be able to generate a picture aside from my camera in here. So I'm almost there, but it's a lot of work. I'm not the most proficient guy using the computer. I hate computers. I hate computers. I spend only the minimum time I really have to when I do something on the computer. So, but that shows that I don't know. I don't know anything. So, enough about me, and I think I'll, I don't know who runs the net. Are you running, Richard? I'll send it back to you, KB16.
Ben is running the net, but I'm providing... the cover video for him tonight.
Okay, do you get that now, Jerry? My picture is lousy, so very simple terms. Richard's got this P5, P20, P50 picture. So he's been congenial enough to do it for me, to keep a picture up. So we have video. And I'm doing the audio side of it. So he's doing the video, I'm doing the audio. Okay, do we have another check-in? Where is... how about Paul? KK6HWN. You with us? How about N6POH? Nick, are you with us? How about Joe, WV6RY? Are you with us?
Still with you.
I thought I'd harass him a little bit. Make sure he didn't fall asleep or run in the other room yet. That's great. Thanks, Joe. Okay. How about K6MFW? Are you with us tonight? Hey, there you be. What's the good word?
Well, anyway, just coming back from the Silicon Valley Engineering Council meeting, we had a speaker that talked about you know, like a new lithium ion batteries that use carbon nanotube technology, and then also a graphene, you know, for like a heat sink.
That sounds really interesting.
Well, we actually had a fairly good turnout. And, you know, of course, I don't really get into battery technologies that much, but it's kind of a new, he showed a chart of about, like, batteries, and they said, supposedly, like, the lithium-ion batteries, you know, lithium, you know, phosphate and all that stuff, that was actually from 1999. So they said that even though they kind of improved charge rates and stuff like that, but battery, you know, technology really hasn't changed much since then. Except probably the big thing would be the carbon, you know, nanotube. And I'm thinking, gosh, 99, it seems like in recent years has been a big thing in batteries.
Can you hear Richard when he talks? Go ahead, Richard.
Hi, Michael. Can you hear me? I think he's on UHF.
Yeah, okay, Michael's on UHF. I just wondering if you heard Richard in there. Richard's on 145.51. You got about five radios in that car. Maybe you could put one on 5.1 and one on the UHF side, 1275.
Yes, K6MF30 back here. Yeah, I'm transmitting on 5.1 and then listening to 431.75, the audio output, because some of the guys come in and out that I cannot hear through the repeater, so I'm doing it this method.
You mean 441.275?
Oh, I'm listening to the audio output of the television signal.
4.5 megahertz higher.
Okay.
That's about kind of like the news I've got so far. Anyway, approaching my condo, so I'm driving underneath the garage, so I'll be signing out. I might get on in a bit with internal radios. All right, talk to you then, K6MF30.
Okay, thanks for checking in, Michael. Have a good one there. And I wonder if Nick went to that meeting. N6DOA, you with us? How about KK6HWN? You with us, Paul? How about KJ6RNL? You with us?
Yes, I am. KJ6RNL.
I can't get over this picture I'm looking at. I mean, this video. This is absolutely unbelievable. I mean, there ain't a better picture on here tonight. You and Don are a match. Total match. I ain't kidding you either. Yeah. Hey, Don, you got something to show us tonight? Don, wake up. Are you sleeping, Don?
Hey, I'm talking to my brother. I'll
tell
you back
to
you
later. Okay, say hi for me. To Steven.
Yeah.
Tell him Ben says hi. Talking to his brother Steven there. Okay, do we have another audio or video check-in tonight? Come now, please. W2NYC, net control for the Silicon Valley ATV group, which meets each and every Wednesday evening here at 8:30. And let's see, what's the date for our next get-together? That's going to be probably around the middle of May there.
Oh. I would have to go over and lift the calendar. Stand by.
Thank you, Richard. We have another check-in here while Richard's bringing up our date for the luncheon.
The 20th of May. That would be on the 20th of May, which is fortunate for me because the following weekend I will be in Sacramento for an antique television collectors get-together event, which we hold once a year. They hold once a year, and they invite me. So I'm going to show one of my cameras, but I'm also rushing another project right now, and that would be on display up there too. So of course I'll have more to report about that after the event. W6ATV will also be there.
Well, if there's any chance of your video in that, that would be nice to share with us. See if you can video that in some way.
Absolutely, absolutely. John Staples from Berkeley is going to be demonstrating his home-built iconoscope television camera, and he has a home-built mechanical television that's not quite standard. He's driving his from a Raspberry Pi computer in a different mode than normal, but it produces the image the same way. And for his spinning scanning disc, he used a 12-inch long play record. It's quite cute.
Oh my God! You got to show us that if he's gonna show it up there. Do you have a video camera to use to bring up?
Do I? I have two. The camera you're seeing me on, and his twin brother, which is currently aimed at my monitor tonight. I have been recording the entire net.
Oh, great, great. If you got a tripod or something, you'll know to swing it into video while you're talking. So we'll get to see everything. Oh, yeah. Well, bring that with you when you go up. That'll be really fun. And we'll get to see it. Yeah.
I take both video cameras with me everywhere I go when I go to an event.
Oh, good, good. Well, that ought to be interesting. So our get-together is on the 20th, and when is your show up there?
I believe it's on the 27th, the following weekend. If my memory serves correctly, and I think that's correct.
Hey, that's great. Looking forward to that. Okay, while you're on camera there, do we have another check-in for the Silicon Valley ATV group? Operating through the K6 band. And once again, our get-together will be on the 20th of May at Harry's Hofbräu on Saratoga Avenue. And I believe that's listed under Santa Fe, if I'm not correct. Okay. And if you go on our webpage, if you go on to the K6 band webpage, you're able to see directions and how to get there and all that good stuff. All right. Who else do we have here? W2NY6, standing by. Okay, hearing none. How about Jerry? Jerry, you got something else for us before we close the net here?
Watch and see how other people do
their ATV net. If you guys interested, again, it's on Tuesdays at 7:30, and they are on BATC just above the Mount Diablo, the indirect repeater. There is a whole column of repeaters you can choose, so you click on the one from the Southern California, and you're on. That's about all I have, KB16.
Okay, thanks for that input there, Jerry. We'll give that a try, see if we can pull them out. Yeah, that's good. All right, does anybody have anything else for the net this evening before we bring it to a close? I'll stand by here. Okay, hearing none. We will close the net here at exactly 8:57. Did I get that right? Yes, 8:57, and Joe doesn't have the right time. 8:57 and 12 seconds.
Right on the money.
I figured that my great, great clock over here. Astronomical, right out of the sun. I mean, it comes from the sky. It's actually one of those satellites up there that beams down on me and gives me the exact time right to the second.
That's very important.
You're something else, Richard. God love you. All right, folks. That's it for the net, but you guys can keep transmitting here as often as you want. She's on. And one of these days, I'll get my transmitter fixed. I'm like Richard, I got to put it off. Okay, but boy, I'll tell you, you made up for lost time, Richard. That is the greatest picture that I've ever seen come out of you there. That is fantastic. And you're basically equal to Don. Oh my God. You and Don have, and Joe, look at that.
Peekaboo.
But you're in there. And of course, Jerry's always putting in a good picture. We don't have any problem with him. W2NYC. Go ahead and pick it up, guys. And I will catch you next week or catch you during the week. Now that he's got this fantastic picture, him and I are going to start transmitting.
I'd like to give Jerry my email address if he's interested. It's, I'll say it fast, richcam1@yahoo.com. That's richcam, as in man, the number 1@yahoo.com. Send me an email and I'll send you a couple of interesting links to things now and then.
Will do. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thanks for running the net, Ben. I am going to be dropping my video here in a moment, and just for general interest to everybody, I'll just repeat it once again. Today I replaced my antenna cable with some LMR400 cable, which I installed the connectors myself, pulled down my antenna mast, and installed the new cable and put everything back up. And while I had the antenna down, I moved it about 3 feet to the left to get away from a tree branch that was just about to touch my Elk 440 antenna. And I think that was screwing up my receive side something fierce. And that receive side problem seems to be fixed as well. KJ6RNL, bidding everyone a good evening. And it's been fun.
Great picture.
Thank you. Yeah, I know. I planned it that way.
Hey, have fun. Play around with it. W2NYC, clear.
Okay, I'll continue to be modest because I have so much to be modest about. KJ6RNL 73. And that is that. Woohoo! End of recording.